Love the Bronx. You know, the Bronx had some tough times years ago, but the Bronx is booming, as they say, with a lot of great things that are happening, including the Eagle Academy. And so the Eagle Academy started here.
Många historier har berättats om The Bronx tuffaste områden i New York, men kanske inte den om Eagle Academy, pojkskolan som sedan 2004 kräver disciplin och uppförande av sina gymnasieelever.
Straighten the line out, fellas, or I have to sit you down.
So many of them in co-ed schools see the girls all day long, and that's all they see. And they don't see their math class and their English class and their writing and the things that they're supposed to be doing to advance themselves academically. Many young men just lose sight of what's important in school.
Back up, right? So you look a little more like me.
Artiga handskakningar med fast blick är vad som möter dig i de här röriga korridorerna. Här har var tredje elev inlärningsproblem. Och bara genom lotteri kan du få plats på skolan där ändå 90% av eleverna tar sin gymnasieexamen.
And the reason that the academy in fact was created was because the graduation rate for African American and Latino males in New York City back in 2004 was only 32%.
When I came here with an all-male environment, I was able to focus more on my work and less on girls.
Can I just drop this in here real quick?
Sure, please.
Thank you. Appreciate you.
Mr. Banks plockar fortfarande skräp i korridorerna och vill vara ett föredöme här i The Bronx. Tanken är att skapa en trygg miljö utan de ofta mer mogna och motiverade tjejeleverna. Men många kritiker menar att de här skolorna motverkar sitt syfte.
Some of these schools can become hypermasculine environments that actually reinforce the very behaviors and the very attributes that are contributing to the underperformance of boys.
Just bringing boys together is not the answer, but it's bringing them together with a curriculum that's focused on them understanding what it means to be a man.
Det är alltså kafeterian. Hit sökte i fjol 5000 elever, de då 124 platser som blev lediga. Många har en strulig studietid bakom sig när man söker hit.
The distraction is not there. They're more focused. I think that the single-sex schools also, with the young men, they're able to give the young men what they need.
Och de skilda skolorna för flickor och pojkar växer nu snabbt här i USA. Och det räknas nu till fler än 500 allmänna skolor i 40 delstater.
To be able to be in a place where they don't have to compete with each other over the girls takes a huge factor right off the table and allows for the young men to just stay focused on their academic core work so that they can achieve their goals.